Now, if you're unfamiliar with the Air Cadets, then hold tight. This is a teenage group pushing the limits. When they're not volunteering in the community, you'll find them involved in outdoor pursuits or even flying planes.
Now one Auckland squadron is facing an uncertain future and needs your help. Here's Lucas de Jong.
Regimented, clinical and clean cut. They're not your usual teenagers.
Like, eyes, front!
Some people like to say that we're New Zealand's best kept secret.
Left side, west!
This is the Central Auckland Air Cadets.
Two faces, right side, west! Punch!
It's a youth organisation with an Air Force flavour. Initially, it was part of the compulsory military training back in World War I and World War II. But it's definitely more of a youth organisation now rather than a direct feed into the Defence Force. Completely voluntary, they come along if they want to.
We have units, I'm from 3 Squadron here. I feel a sense of belonging, it's like a family pretty much.
For the one shy Roshni, it's been a life changer.
Yep, Delaher, if you want to step on top.
It's insane how much this organisation teaches you. It gives you opportunities to learn, to grow. It's taught me so many leadership skills.
How much of this is the real deal, mate? I mean, the uniform, the ranks, the parading.
It's pretty much like the real deal. It's obviously less harsh because it is for mostly under 18. I've learnt how to camp in the outdoors. I've learnt flying. I've learnt how to shoot a rifle.
Most of everything is included. So these boots were given to me. The uniform was given to me. Everything on camps, the tents, sometimes even the ration packs, the food is provided for us.
Seeing someone come into a unit who at the start wouldn't even want to introduce themselves to then be at a stage where they're standing up in a group of 30 people and delivering a 40-minute lesson.
General happiness.
Watching that confidence grow and their skills grow is really amazing.
If the kids are this organisation's heart, then the building is its body.
The Air Force donated two of these barracks from the Hobsonville Air Force Base, which is being decommissioned. So we've got an indoor training centre, 2 lecture rooms, a set of offices. It was purpose-built, it's absolutely unique.
My very first year in cadets was finishing off fundraising for this building, so I have been in this building on this site since we first moved in here in 2003. I've spent a lot of time here.
And that's where the story takes a sad turn. Their 20-year lease is about to expire, and the land is going to be developed.
Over the past year or so, we've been sort of reaching out to sort of local schools, colleges, whatever else, to see if they have any available land. Finding that much land in this part of Auckland is very difficult.
And it just feels like home. And taking that away or moving, it just doesn't feel right. It just feels really sad.
And so Auckland, a plea for a place to lease. Somewhere to share these buildings.
Well, we'd be definitely offering the facility for use by others or the community.
And you guys aren't looking for a handout?
No. This was a commercial proposition when we first started.
For now, they've found temporary accommodation, but they're not sure for how long.
This isn't going to be the end of 3 Squadron, though, is it?
No, absolutely not.
No. You guys will continue on, just not sure where yet.
Yeah.